Genesis chapter 17, verse 1, the Lord speaks to Abraham saying, I am the Lord Almighty. Walk before me faithful and blameless. Our God is the Almighty. If we read Psalm 24, verse 1, it says, the earth and all its fullness belong to Yahweh. The world and all that is dwelling in it, He directs them. The whole Bible teaches us this important truth that this world belongs to God and all its belongs to the Lord. The Lord has created the world. The Lord directs every human being. He brings human being in His time for a purpose. Is the Lord? Hallelujah. 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 So the whole Bible teaches us that the world is created by God. He is the Almighty. And the earth is created by Him for His purpose. That's why in Psalm 127, verse 3, it is written, the children are the heritage of the Lord. The human beings who are living on this earth are God's gift to the humanity. You and I are given to God, given to our parents by God as a gift. And we don't belong to them. We are given that they may train us. That's why in Proverbs chapter 22 we read, train the child as he should grow, not as he wants to go. Train the child as he should grow. Yes, each one of us are sent by the Lord into this world. This world is not ours. This life is also not about us. God has given us life to fulfill His purpose. That's why in Psalm 138, verse 8, the psalmist says, the Lord will fulfill His purpose for me on this earth. The greatest tragedy with man is, man thinks life is his. Man thinks life, I have to build up myself. Life is not about us. Life is a gift received from God to do the work of God, to do the plan of God. God has a purpose to place us in this particular time for a particular purpose. And God is watching over us, watching over everything that we do. When we do not move according to the plan of God, He constantly prunes us. He constantly affects us. He constantly trains us that we should be in His hands to fulfill His purpose in our lives. But man, sometimes he doesn't understand. That's why Jesus said in John chapter 15, verse 1, I am the vine, you are my branches, and the branches that doesn't bear fruit, my Father, He prunes them, He cuts them. God watches over us. God is at work in us to fulfill the purpose for which we are created. But man, not recognizing the truth that my life is not about us, not about me. I am here sent by God for God. Colossians 1:16. I am created by God for God. And I am here to be with Him, to spend time with Him, to listen to Him. If anything is wrong, I cannot find it out by myself because I have not created myself. My intellect cannot produce the answer. If something is gone wrong, I have to go to God and He will teach me what's wrong, what has to be done. So we have come from God to fulfill God's purpose. And until we move away from the purpose of God, God will go on prune us, which we call it a problem, struggle, weakness, so many things. That's why in one of his books, Augustine says, until I was pruned, I went through misery. God lifts him up, but this fellow doesn't listen to God. He falls back to his flesh. Again, God has to hit him and lift him up once again. He grows, again he falls into the flesh, and God has to hit him, take him back. So God is constantly at work in us, that we may be in His hands to fulfill the purpose of God. We read in the book of Daniel chapter 4. One day Daniel was called by the king called Nebuchadnezzar. And the king says, I had a dream. And in the dream I saw a huge tree. And I saw beautiful fruits, wonderful branches, birds building their nests. And one day I heard the voice, a watcher who was watching the tree. And he said, cut down the tree. And the tree was cut with the stump. The stump was left out. And I saw the birds ran away, the branches withered away, the fruits became dried up, and it became a horrible sight. And after 7 years, the stump started to once again grow. And I heard a voice saying, give him the heart of the animal. Daniel, what is this meaning? Daniel said, O king, this vision is about you. You are created to glorify God. You stupidly thinking life is yours, kingdom is yours, heaven, palace is yours, you can do whatever you want. No. God gives everything for a purpose to every individual. If He has made you king, for a purpose. If He has made you a priest, for a purpose. If He has made you a sweeper, there is a purpose. And being united with God, we realize what we are to do on this earth. And as He said to Abraham, remain faithful and blameless before me. We constantly hear Him telling us, walk before me. Children are my heritage, not yours. You are mine. So king, you have to honor the Lord. You have to glorify God. But you have become a man of pride. You are attaching yourself to your property. You think it is yours. You take decision as you wish. No, you cannot take. You cannot roam around with anybody and everybody. Sorry. Because you are a king, you cannot take the wife of somebody else. No. God is watching over you. And He has found you. You are not doing His purpose. So he is going to cut down. Be careful. If you repent for your sin and return to God, his mercy will come upon you. And his purpose has to be fulfilled. Live your life for his purpose. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.